One important question which is often asked in the Principles of Management course is, what is leadership grid? Sometimes the question is, what is managerial grid? So managerial grid is now known as leadership grid. The leadership grid is actually, it's a model of behavioral leadership which was developed in the 1960s by Robert Blake and Jane Mouton. So it is called Blake and Mouton grid. This is essentially based upon two behavioral dimensions, and it is plotted on a graph. On the x-axis, you put the figure in terms of concern of a manager for production or for achievement, you know. So if it is a factory manager, how much is he concerned about production? If he's a sales manager, his concern for the revenue numbers, the top line number or the bottom line number or whatever, you know, number of units sold. So on the x-axis, the manager's concern for production or sales. So you can call it task achievement axis, x-axis. On the y-axis is the manager's concern for people. So x-axis, task orientation. On the y-axis, people's orientation. And normally, on the x-axis as well as the y-axis, it is a scale of 1 to 9. So 1, 2, 3, 4, so 9 and 9. So I have explained that in the next slide. So this model, it identifies 5 leadership styles, or you can say 5 managerial styles. You can say by the relative position on the grid. By the relative position on the grid. The first number is, for example, 1, 1. If on the x-axis also, the concern for production is 1 and the concern for people is also 1. So it is low for x-axis also, y also. So 1, 1 is impoverished position. And if it is 9, very high for concern for production or for result. So 9, but people concern is low. It is 9, 1. So 1, 1, 9, 1, as you go up, it will be x-axis 1 and 9, and then there is 9, 9, and then there is something called middle of the road. I will explain it to you in the next slide, and it will be more clear to you, but it's a very interesting grid, which was given by Blake and Mouton. So let me dwell more on this managerial grid. So one position in which the manager is low on task orientation as well as low on people orientation, it is called impoverished management. So you have low people orientation and your results are also very low. So you are this type of a leader who is indifferent both to the people and to result. Maybe you're not even interested in the job, you're not interested in getting the job done, or you're not interested in keeping a team motivated. So in such kind of a management style, tasks are generally completed to the standard required by the organization with great amount of difficulty, and mostly they are not achieved. The standards are not achieved. Somebody is doing his job, a manager is performing his function just because he happens to be in this position, and such managers are able to stay afloat for some time, but sooner or later, you know, they get caught in this web of indifference and they have to leave. But sometimes you can use this leadership style, and it is only advisable to use this style if your team is highly motivated team and you have highly competent team. Perhaps then you can adopt this impoverished management, but then, you know, you must use it with caution. Impoverished management. The second style is when you are very high, when you are very high on results, you are mad about results, but you are not too concerned about people. This is called produce or perish management or extreme task management. You know, in this kind of a thing may be required when you need drastic change. You need to completely change the team. So this is something like, if you recall the McGregor's theory X, this is McGregor's theory X kind of leadership. You are extremely autocratic. and you see a team, your team, as tools to achieve the end result. You can produce great results, but maybe it will be short-lived because, you know, your team's morale will taper off. Your team's morale will taper off. So you may achieve results, but, you know, your team will have turnover. Your people may leave you. So you can use this during a crisis period when there are urgent situations, when you need to turn around things, then you can adopt this kind of a leadership, which is 9-1, producer perish management style. After that, let us take the third style, which is called the middle of the road. So middle of the road, actually, you know, middle of the road means you are able to strike a balance between your yearning or your drive for achievement, but also taking good care of people, also taking good care of your people. You have struck a balance between the two. At first glance, this kind of thing may look very good, and it is actually good, but you know, you are not able to really push your team very high. You're not able to push your team hard for results. And team is happy, you achieve results, but you don't perhaps achieve fantastic results. You don't achieve fantastic results. Your team is happy. Perhaps the more creative guys in your team may not be very satisfied. You know, when you need to achieve something very big, this kind of a leadership style may not achieve those results. But mostly, you know, if you decide to leave things on your team, and if your team is good, this style of management may be appropriate. Sometimes it may also happen that the leader, it is very important, leader wants to concentrate on higher priorities. So leader is concerned about strategy and he leaves day-to-day management, monthly targets on the team to achieve. This is a good leadership style then. Fourth is country club management. Country club management means you're very high on people's skill, but you're not passionate about results. So guys are very happy. They're extremely motivated, but the achievement is very little. The achievement is very little. So is this style completely useless? Mostly it is useless, but sometimes you need to adopt this style also, especially when your team is extremely tired, when your team is facing a burnout situation. You know, if you have achieved month-on-month results, you have achieved very high results month-on-month, then, you know, once in a while you can let people go and, you know, enjoy. Because if you don't do it, a highly motivated team, which is driven by a very highly motivated task-oriented manager, it can feel the burnout. So it's not good for long-term strategy. If you use it for long-term strategy, that, you know, then you will head to disaster. And the fifth is team management. This is high people, high result. 9-9. Team is also extremely motivated. You are able to motivate the team and you are able to drive the team for higher and higher results. So this is the best, isn't it? This is the best. But it is a utopian state. It does not happen all the time. It does not happen all the time. This kind of a thing you can correlate to the McGregor's theory why leadership style. Okay? But such kind of a leadership is, as I said, it is mainly a utopian stage. But you should try to strive. You should try to strive for this kind of a leadership position. You should try to achieve this, but there could be a chance the leader himself may burn out. You know, very difficult to achieve this kind of a leadership. So by this managerial grid, I have explained to you all the five leadership styles. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any suggestions, you can email me at s.bist@dme.ac.in. Thank you very much.